Okay, so this next game is CP Execution
versus Mua Women.
And I'm Susan.
And I'm Zoe, and we will be your commentators.
And I must admit right at the beginning here that CP Execution is my team, and I'm injured, so I'm a little bit biased. Though, of course, I'm hoping for a really awesome game.
I will attempt to balance out that bias, but no promises.
Yeah. Heroism will always make me cheer, no matter who does it.
Layouts for the win.
So we're a bit late starting because there was an epic universe point at the end of the men's game just before. A very exciting game. Here we are. People getting on the line. Endeavor will have to get off the field.
That's the previous men's team that still haven't left.
So, can we have a guest spot?
Hello.
So, this is Renee from Mua.
Yes, indeed.
And can you tell us a bit about Mua while we're waiting? Who's on the line?
Absolutely. So, Ultimate in Palmerston North is pretty small, so we're really working on a development team.
Mua is green, I'm afraid. I'll just mention that because the camera's pointing at the team that will be coming out on defence.
Yeah. And so we've got quite a lot of new players, which is awesome. We've also managed to pick up a few ring-ins from around the country. So we have Caitlin and Sierra from Auckland, and we have Chi-Chi from Tauranga. So, we also have Liz from Wellington. So we're a bit of a national-based team, and we've all come together for nationals.
Right, so starting off with a pass to a handler and centering the disc and going straight down the field.
And the put goes up, ooh, but it is D'd.
D from Helena.
Capital punishment sets up. There's a nice bid from Hillary, but she just misses. Now Mu is setting up their stack. The disc comes in.
M nice down the sideline.
Oh, and she just catches it. And a score from Sierra.
I wonder if someone's going to score that over there.
That's probably my tardiness not scoring that. So when I hobble back over, I will adjust the score.
Right. Well, we're happy to have you with us in the meantime anyway. And we can keep score on this piece of paper. Oh, yes. There's one of the other capital punishment people starting off the score. So that's Beth. She's been coaching us this last season. As you might have been able to tell from the side-on view, she's sidelined because of pregnancy. And we're looking forward to hopefully another new player in another 10 years.
I thought 6 was the age we were starting them at now.
Good plan.
There's and the pull goes up. It's a nice pull. Nice in the field.
Caught by Stephanie to Penny. Sophie, Stephanie. Oh, out to Sarah. Not quite making that grab.
Mua sets up. We've got quite a deep stack.
Elizabeth with the
swinging
with
it
the
across
stick.
The field.
Emily. Looking for a downfield option. Yes.
Nice put, and they've got some flow. swings all the way across. A lovely put goes up. And they just jump into the end zone. That was an impressive catch.
Who was that? Liz. So you picked her up from Wellington?
Yes.
A little bit embarrassing, I didn't recognize her.
Liz has been our super sub for a number of years. She really enjoys the Palmerston North relaxed style of play. So she comes in and helps us out at random tournaments, so it's really awesome to have that extra pool of people who'll come play with us, so it's great.
So is she playing with you at Welly Windup?
Actually, Tommy didn't do Welly Windup, so this is our one and only hurrah. So unfortunately, we have a lot of university students in our team, and the Welly Windup's just too early in the season to get those students
there. Yeah, they're still
there.
Distributed.
Yeah, so we... and Christchurch was a bit too logistically challenging. So this is our one and only tournament as a women's team. So we're really excited to be here.
Cool. And how have you been going?
Really good. We're really pleased with our results. We haven't won a game, but we pushed Christchurch Chickers to 7-8 at halftime, but they took it away at the end.
Yep.
But yeah, really enjoying the tournament.
Oh, fun.
A nice flat pull was just put up by Moore.
Helena in the very free in the middle there. Back to her handler, Emma. Emma to Farron. Back to Emma.
And it is a turn.
Okay, looking for an option.
Some nice strong cuts. Disc is swung, but it is not caught.
Okay, they've called execute. I can tell you that's one of our end zone plays. It has three handlers across the zone and a ISO rotation. There we are. Farron getting the point. From Emma. Execute looking very good there. We'll use that as a training video. You can watch this as a resource for your team too.
Absolutely. This I was saying to the team that this is a really good opportunity to actually go back and have a look at different things about how the play's going, and it's quite an exciting opportunity to actually see yourself play.
Yeah. Last night I listened to the games that I commentated yesterday. I'm pretty sure I've learnt something already.
That's brilliant.
How to commentate. Hopefully doing better today.
It's a learning curve. It's always a learning curve.
It is.
So we've got Margaret there calling the line in the white hat, number 8. She's one of our sturdy handlers. And... look like they're pretty much organised, ready for the next point.
On our line, we have Arnie, one of our captains with the disc. She's been living in Palmerston North lately, so hopefully she'll have some things to say about how to play against Moore. She's about to pull. Nice, floaty. There is no wind here, and it's not too hot. It's so lovely. I wish I was playing.
This is perfect ultimate weather. Nice upfield pass to Sandy.
She's looking around.
She's looking for the next option. Stump back. We see a nice flow pass go up.
She is the next option.
And another one.
Oh.
Nice pass.
Got a hand to it. Yeah, got a hand to it. But, yeah. Nice D, Jackie. Keep on her. Okay, so we have Penny coming up with the disc. Penny was living in Wellington for a little while between Christmas and now, but she's come from Timaru this morning. And she had to move there for work. She's played Ultimate in 4 different countries. And was on the Hong Kong women's team for Asia Oceania Ultimate Championships.
And another put goes up to Sandy. Nice continuation. Where's her next option? She's looking. Another continuation. Nice. Oh, a lady pass goes up, but it is caught by Sandy.
Thank you very much for the chance to talk to you.
Thank you, Renee, for talking to us. So you'll see, walking across the field with her knee bandage, that's Renee, who was just helping us out there.
We say walking. It's an interpretation of walking.
Hi, Chewy the Wookie 69. Shouting out to Izzy. Okay, hands are up. Disc is
another
up.
Another nice floaty pull goes up.
Caught by my daughter, Hazel. She was on the New Zealand mixed team for AOUC that Penny was on the Hong Kong women's.
Punt goes up.
Oh! Hillary's fast, but didn't quite get there.
Maybe the layout was needed.
Or the slightly shorter throw.
Either would have been a good option.
Slightly different angle. All these things.
The disc is back in. Moore seems to be setting up their pearl play again. They're waiting for that pass, and it goes up. Oh, but it is slightly too high.
To Leah, also known as Sheila. Sophie. Another player. Oh, scooped up by Sarah.
Nice backer.
Nice hands. Sophie's another person on capital punishment execution who has been living in Palmerston North. So there's some friends here on both teams. So Ultimate is a self-refereed sport, and our perceptions are quite inaccurate of what happens before what else. And people can go back with slow motion and look at stuff and see what was really the case at the time. But actually Ultimate is all about what you could feel and what you believed in this referee's, which is each person has a referee inside themselves, and you make a call and you talk about it.
If you have never played Ultimate, this concept will be very foreign to you. I've tried to explain it to many a person. They're gone, and they have asked me, how on earth does that work?
The answer is you just are honest and you do being a good person.
This pool is being bricked.
So it landed outside.
And they get to take it from the middle of the field since it did not land in the field.
Farron having a wee dance there. She's number 71.
Discus tapped in. And a lovely floaty pass is put up. And it is caught from one of the further down players. A dump back and a nice break throw. It's easily caught. And a nice huck goes up.
Oh,
just missed by the defender. Nice put.
Good work, Sylvia. Next time.
A call is being made, however.
A travel
was called on the throw.
And
a discussion is going on.
And they've decided it's a point. No.
They may be discussing the throw before the throw was a travel. This is just what we were talking about before with the self-refereeing. Everyone is happily joining in the discussion of what occurred.
Okay, so. Okay, so Beth, our coach, is saying that's unfortunate. You need to make the yell more assertively so that the communication is clear.
Timeout has just been called by execution. They are huddling up now. Moore has also gathered on the other side of the field. Important tactics will now be discussed.
And on the field behind these two fields, we can see a Wildcats team. I think it's Epsilon.
Which is their B team, am I correct?
I thought this was one of the other letters. This
no,
is young.
Is, yeah.
Okay, so this is young people who've mostly been to Worlds as under 20s. I'm sure your eyes are better than mine.
I believe that is the B team over there.
Okay, cool.
I believe.
And some blue people. Who would blue be?
I do not recognize that team.
I'll see if my thing tells me. Schedule tells me names of teams.
But a nice huck was just put up by that unknown team. And a nice grab.
That grab.
And finished off with a point.
Okay, so that's Wildcats Omicron versus Mammoth. I didn't recognize them. They don't look like hairy elephants.
Where is Mammoth from?
Queensland.
Oh, so an Australian team come to compete. We can't let the Aussie throw us up. Not on home ground.
Yeah, work on it, Omicron.
A beautiful pole just got put up on the boys' field across. So floaty. They've chased it down well. But the girls are just going back on the field from their timeout. We hope to see some very strategic play come out of this. Moore has just done their cheer and they are also re-entering the field.
Right, so people taking the field again after that timeout. Don't know what Kim was saying, but it will have been something encouraging and interesting and helpful, because I've been listening to her all season and she has always been encouraging and helpful and interesting. Disc is up.
Slight fumble by execution. Let's see if Moore makes the most of it. A huck has gone up. It is well read. Nice grab. Using patience. And in layout, was she in? Yes, she is in the field.
Exciting.
Beautiful catch.
Okay, so Moore have the disc after getting that point. Em's having a little talk to them, possibly about the force. That's a gesture that often looks like talking about the force to me. CP have their hand up.
Another nice flat pole.
Picked up by Hazel. To Emma.
Just put it. Those up.
Nice
both
throw.
Sprinting for the disc.
Emma and
both.
Hillary couldn't quite get round.
Execution
it.
Was boxed out. Rather curvy pass, and she almost gets there, but she fumbles the disc. Execution have another chance.
Emma picking up. Can't put through to Hillary. Cross to Liv. Down and in. Don't know. Sophie wasn't quite coming to that spot.
Moore has set back up again in their same pearl as before, using their open swing. And another nice floaty one put up.
Go, Hazel.
Sandy's brought it down. Nice break throw. And another break. competed for that pass, but Moore just came through and caught it. And another one put up. Nice pass, straight to the receiver.
Oh,
and just too low for her to catch.
Okay, CP. Treasure the disc. That's what I want from my team right now.
Many people under the disc.
Oh,
execution
yeah.
comes out with it, however. Slightly too fast for Hillary, and that's pretty difficult to do.
When one has made a really good catch, sometimes it seems like the throw is harder than it was normally, as if your brain hasn't finished catching and is still using some resources on that or something.
Execution has adjusted their defense to Moore's pearl, making it more difficult for them.
Hazel are working very hard.
This time they yeah! could not get the disc to the center player.
Nice job, Sarah.
Nice grab. Lovely handler movement we're seeing from execution.
Live to Sophie for the goal. Thinking of training video situations, we have a cutting sequence for the vertical stack from before we get into flow to help us get into flow on execution, where the last person cuts open and the second person cuts break. And I'm curious to see whether that's what we're doing or whether we're doing a different one, because I wasn't quite sure in that last point.
Though you said training, and all I can think of is this their comeback train? Have they gotten on board?
Doot, doot!
They're only 2 points down. The game is still anyone's. Lovely pull put up by execution, floating. Original swing. Keep swinging it across the field. And back, a nice break. However, Muha do seem to be working it backwards. A nice upfield pass, lovely grab from number 22.
Oh,
and
yeah.
a lovely D.
Steph gets that off Liz. Sideline yells, Steph poached. It. Oh yeah, Farron jumping in.
Farron left her feet.
Beautiful hands, nice catch. Always good to see, and always smiley. Oh, you should see our coach dancing. She is so happy. She has worked so hard with us.
They're continuing on the comeback train, only 1 point in it now. Farron is now complaining about how she had to jump because it gave her ground shock.
Zoe and Farron are good mates.
Would you like to say anything,
played
Farron?
Played on Kahoo together.
Frisbee for life.
Inspirational words from Farron there.
We'll do live streaming.
So who do we have on? Sylvia, Jackie, Hazel, Steph, Jess, Beth, and Leah.
Mua seemed to just be intensely discussing what to do about this oncoming comeback train. But they seem ready now. Working it up the field till the defense gets there. And again, have set up their pearl play, but using their handlers slightly more this time. A lovely down the line cut. An uncontested foul on that catch.
Strip,
foul, that one.
And a long put. Go, Hazel.
And it is taken down by Mua.
Get that force on.
And another pass, but just too high.
Defense flustering the throw a little bit, I like to think.
Possibly some very hard pressure from the defense just there.
Steph to Beth. Beth to Leah. Oh! Steph's magnet hands not engaged that time. She has superpowers sometimes.
Moore picking it up quickly. Still using those handler passes. And down the line, but Justine!
CP setting up.
And now backhand force down the line from Mua.
Horizontal.
That force is just broken, but it was too high for the swing pass.
Okay. So we're going to try and get it back before they get this point. Everyone's very alert.
And it goes up. Just goes over everyone's fingertips.
A lot of people contesting for that disc. Ground got it.
Sadly, the ground is on neither team. That would be quite unfair.
Yeah. Steph picks up. Nice throw from Leah. Oh, speaking of superpowers, she's left-handed.
I personally believe that is cheating in Ultimate, though it is not written into the rules.
It's not cheating. It's awesome. Oh.
An attempted greatest, but no success. The greatest is when you realize you cannot keep your feet in the field while catching. And so you must jump out and throw it back in before you land out of bounds. It is very difficult to pull off.
But it's always worth trying. Occasionally, it's so amazing. Go, Hazel.
Nice up the line throw from Moore. So there does not appear to be another option. Back to the handler.
Hardy.
A huck, but no lux to the ground.
So execution is capital punishment second team, which means that we are the people who are less fit or newer or have less time or are just not as amazing as our top team. And we play our top team quite a lot. So our defense is amazing because we play our top team and we score.
Nice D from number 65. Reading that disc well.
But all those other things you really need to have the time and the effort for, which are part of O.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Hazel may have just tipped that and put the receiver off.
Nice cut, Hazel.
Moa keeping that strong forehand force and a D. Getting that flow moving quickly.
Get it back.
And they're keeping it going. Nice grab. They've been stopped as the defense has caught up. A low pass, but it is caught. And a put goes up. Quite floaty.
Nice.
But it is caught by Moa.
Five.
That goal was just scored by Sierra. I'm slowly learning names.
Actually 6-4. Someone put the score on the wrong side.
Moore have now interrupted the comeback train.
Still two down is quite a nice place to be for a short time.
Execution can still recover.
Goals in sight and can play pretty hard at two down. It's really obviously still doable.
Maybe the problem is once they are no longer two down, they let up on the fire.
So they just need to think they're two down all the time until we win. I mean, you know.
Maybe that is what they really need. We should just not change the scoreboard. Then they might do better. They'll constantly think they are two down.
Yeah, but that would be confusing for us.
They're ready to go.
Right, Moa's got their disc up. Execution have their hands up.
Farron is dancing.
Beautiful.
Getting the positive vibes flowing in the team.
Helena, little throw.
Strong forehand pass, forcing that sideline.
To Liv, back to Helena.
But they have been broken.
Oh,
nice pick up by Moa, as it just misses the execution player. Nice chili by Moa. They're not rushing anything too much. Swing wide open, they will take that option.
So when Zoe was on the under-20s girls, they had this chant that I thought was the best cheer ever. Chili O, Psycho D.
Every disc belongs to me. Chili O, Psycho D. Every disc belongs to me.
And I think that really is just all I want from my ultimate, is trying to play like that. And I'm seeing some very Chili O here, people thinking hard.
They're at least taking some of the motto. A nice break swing.
And
they finally initiated their pearl. The continuation pass low, but is caught. Waiting for the right option, it is put up. And the goal. And that's what Chili O does for you. Just got to wait for that opportunity.
Hoping for a bit more Psycho D. Or maybe just no turnovers. Either would do me. Go on, execution.
See, but the no turnovers is the last part. Every disc has to belong to you.
Yeah.
Then you won't ever turn it over. Yes. You do win if you don't turn it over. Moa's ready to pull again.
Beautiful.
High curvy pull, but lands nicely in the field. And the team plenty of time to set up on defense.
Still get a pass off without defense there yet. Two passes. Oh, through to Sarah in the middle.
It's a nice grab.
Cross to Sophie.
Moore's defense has just recovered.
In front of Steph, what a lovely pass.
Nice hop. Can anybody pull it down? No, not quite, but it was a lovely look. Hillary was there.
Lovely flow. Lovely put. Last one. A bit enthusiastic, maybe. Okay, getting it back. That's the plan.
Set up the pearl again. But, oh, Leah gets her hand to it, but it is still caught. These are unfortunate times.
Well, for the Mua supporter,
nice grab.
Pretty pleasing.
A lovely throw down the line, but it just isn't caught. Execution working it up the field. Not quite chilly enough this time from execution. They've put it long again. Mua's taking their time to set up. But their defense is too good. That pass, not good enough. The high release backhand was gone through on the throw. It's just too wobbly. Not enough spin.
Okay, Chile O. And as Zoe was saying just before the game, that means hard cuts still, just very calm choices.
Like that one, they're not quite caught. Lovely pass.
Liz has the disc again.
Curvy pass goes up. Oh, and it is just deed by someone coming in to poach.
Nice job, Hillary.
Much more aggression from the disc we're seeing. More of that psycho D. A break throw goes up. Nice.
And Hillary grabs it. Ultimate's been going in New Zealand since the middle 90s, and we're now seeing quite a few second-generation players, and Hillary Sheridan is one of those.
Mua has just called a timeout. Maybe they are being scared by this comeback train. They are still 2 points up. I, too, myself, am a second-generation Ultimate player, but my dad started in the US, so they've been playing it over there for a bit longer than we've been playing it over here.
And my Hazel is a second generation Ultimate player because I'm a first generation Ultimate player. And she's been coming to Ultimate since she was 4 and playing since she was 11. And it's really interesting how people who've been doing that can read a disc.
I can remember a time going to Nelson Ultimate, where I grew up, and it being the beach, and about halfway through I would get bored and build sandcastles. I was about 8 years old, so no one really marked me. I just kind of run around. But it is a good way to start learning. You think it's the best thing in the world to play with all these adults around you, like you're real cool?
Yeah. Well, you are.
I mean, you are. You're playing Ultimate. You are cool.
Okay, and we're looking at different games. I was perfectly happy to talk about that. Our camera team said that I don't have to, but I'm feeling nattery.
We can refer back over to the boys in the other field, though a discussion seems to be going on.
I think it's actually way down that way. Yeah, they're just looking at different things to see how many teams are playing, which is like 22 or something, this Nationals. Yeah, so this is just men's and women's because we have mixed it at a different time of year so that we can play the same people.
so that you can be involved in both your gender and a mixed team
and get to play all forms of Ultimate as much as physically possible.
Yeah, Ultimate players, they like to play Ultimate as much as physically possible, plus a little bit more.
Hence why we are often injured.
Okay, so... Execution train.
Very hyped up cheer from execution.
Yeah. A little bit of a bouncing, a little bit of dancing.
Rearing up for that Psycho D.
And I imagine Mua are saying we just need to keep doing what we're doing. We're doing fine. So we asked, did we used to sing songs back to the other team back in the day? I actually don't know, because I only started playing when I was 37. We do have some players here who can tell us that. But yeah, I heard about people doing that in Australia and America, that you make up a song as part of your spirit stuff at the end, and it describes the game.
My dad's team used to do that back when he first played. It was, you had to make up a song about the other team's name, and that was like your cheer for them at the end. It has gone out of fashion. It's not quite a song. Often, more commonly these days, if there's time, you'll play a spirit game in between the two teams. So, some weird, wacky game that Frisbee players have invented.
You're probably too young to know this, but pretty much all of them are familiar to me as drinking games. And I love that we can do that just high
completely
on Frisbee.
Sober.
Yeah, and I don't have to feel hungover or anything, because I so don't have the urge to drink anymore, ever.
That is an uncommon opinion amongst Frisbee players.
If more of them were 48, more of them would have that opinion.
Quite possibly true. However, sometimes I am led to believe that on Sunday mornings, the cure for your Saturday night party hangover is more alcohol.
Ew.
Another pull goes up from execution.
Oh, so floaty.
Back to the game.
And not even one pass off before the D was there.
Looking for their pearl.
They're playing.
Nice.
Something interesting here.
Got to that middle pearl player, but no continuation available. Back to the handlers. Swinging, using those break options.
We've got some poaching on the break side. And a very flat force, just creating heaps and heaps of throws.
But Mua is keeping a calm head. Nice, they finally get it to that pearl player and a continuation. Back to the handlers. Mua keeping a very cool head about this, using that chili O. Nice grab on that swing pass. Back into the middle. The handler's just working up the field, nice and calm. And getting to that pearl player again.
Trying to poach a bit, make the throw slightly harder.
So that they cannot get to that pearl player, and that's why you are seeing so much handler movement.
And pushing the throws across into the edges.
To that pearl player again. Almost got to by Hazel, but not quite.
Very active on the mark there.
Back to the handler.
It's always
another
discup.
Nice grab and a continuation.
Oh.
And a goal. The Moor had to work really hard for that goal. Some really nice defense played there.
And really nice O. Just looking calm, keeping it together under all that pressure. I guess it's half time. No one's put that eighth point on yet, but yeah.
Now we go into half time. Both teams get a bit of a break. Pull their heads back into the game.
And we get a break too. Or we can keep chatting. We've got the execution is straight in front of the commentating gazebo.
And the two U20s players from the previous team seem to be fighting each other. Interesting, interesting team dynamics.
And the coach, Kim, is talking to people.
High strats in there.
One of the things that's cool about execution is there's an awful lot of players. And we're all ears. And in these circles, we just have our coaches talking. Pretty much. And it's worked really well. Ooh, replays. Cool. Look at that. It's one of those exciting grabs from Moore. And here we go. Execution.
A lovely break throw.
That was that play that we talked about.
They're very proud to pull off their set end zone play. A lovely high pass from execution.
Oh, just grabbed by Sophie.
And a lovely backup as it goes over Hillary Fuss. Is that Hillary?
Now we have a Mua layout.
Lovely layout there. Nice commitment to the point.
Nice landing too. I keep going to layout clinics.
That amazing D by Steph, lulling the person she's marking to a false sense of security.
There is no security when Steph's on you. High jump, grab.
And we remember this is where Farron got ground shock because she is so unused to leaving the ground.
Be kind.
Lovely D there from Beth. The offender really wanted to keep it in the end zone. And so did not go continue running for the disc. That was a Mua D from one of the execution hucks. Another huck.
Oh, that's right. The one with the IO and the beautiful catch.
A lovely read.
Yeah, and such a nice throw. Scooping it up.
Not the easiest throw there to catch. Bit low. The receiver manages.
Yeah, I can't quite see which receiver it is, but I'm pretty sure she's the one who has the amazing control, like yoga control over her body. And she can scoop up things from all around her far further than you think someone could reach who's only that big.
It's a very exciting play. That time D successful before. She still managed to scoop it up after the discus D.
Execution cheering in the background. Singing, oh what a wonderful feeling. Everything's going my way. I think that's their plan for the future. Throwing.
Giving herself even more confidence. Mua, on the other hand, taking a more relaxed approach. They seem to be all sitting down on the sideline, some doing some stretches.
So we have on the other side of the field, Leah picking up the disc. Throwing to Steph in the middle. Emma throwing to the ground. Arnie picking up the disc now. Emma not quite grabbing it. Come on, Emma! I see you. You can do better than this. See, that's a better throw. Penny and Hazel, two of the handlers, throwing to each other.
Farron falls down as Hillary tries to hit her in the back of the head with the frisbee.
Penny's Irish. We should get her on the mic. She has such a beautiful way of talking. I just like people talking from other places, really. Maybe we should get lots of foreigners to talk. It's always interesting. Hazel has the hat. Down the end, Hillary jumping high, throwing with Farron, who didn't quite get that one.
Half the execution team now has a different strategy from throwing. They are eating lollies.
Yeah, lolly eating. Good plan. Energy is like magic.
Better plan, and offering it to the commentators.
Us lollies. How kind. Thank you.
Thank you.
Are you enjoying your game?
Yes, I am. Sorry, I'm eating as well.
That's Anka. We shall point her out to you next time she's on.
She's number 62.
Yeah. The kind, lolly-giving person. People are bringing it in.
For their cheer. Halftime is almost over.
What's the solution? Execution. It's a pun. What's the solution? Execution, as in killing. But also, what's the solution? Execution, as in executing a plan. Doing the thing that you plan.
Doing the thing, very important. Execution's rearing to go. Mua also has retaken the field.
Disc and yeah, green with the pull. We're looking at execution at the moment. They've got their hand up. Here comes the pull. It's up.
It's a roller. It's going to roll further downfield, however.
Stopped by Steph.
They get a few passes off before the defense gets set.
Through the middle. That nice thing about getting before the defense is set.
Lovely working it up the field. A hop goes up. Lots of people under the disc.
And Hillary.
Nice goal for execution.
Steph to Hillary. That last point, it was really nice. Beautiful read,
too. Execution has come out from halftime firing. They definitely executed there.
And again, come on, people. You're up to 6-8.
Mua having an intense discussion about what just happened. They might need to pick their game up. They need to bring the intensity, too.
Not quite yet. I'm hoping for one of those really exciting universe point wins for my team. That's what I'd really like. Really exciting all the way until then, because it's so fun watching this game, because it is tight and people are working really hard. And then my team winning, because that would be so fun. Helena got the disc up there. I'm not sure whether she or Hazel is the youngest player on execution. I think they're both 15.
Execution getting set really quickly. A lovely full field swing, but they cannot get to their pearl.
Very hard.
A lovely break forehand, but too far in front of the player. She cannot get there.
Very active marks. Nice.
Break throw. Lovely active marks from Moore. We're seeing bidding on that throw. Break.
Nice dishy little backhand.
Lots of movement from execution.
Oh yeah!
Just past the defender's fingertips, straight to the execution player.
Yeah, that's what I mean about Steph's superpower with grabs. Sometimes it's really there and it's so beautiful. Who threw that? Did you see?
I do not know who threw that. I cannot remember.
Oh, yeah. Helena. Helena threw that.
Only 1 point in this game now. Execution has come out of halftime, back on their comeback train.
And they are looking pretty excited about it.
Can they keep this going? Or will Mua step up to the challenge?
Helena, come into our guest spot. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Helena, say a few words.
Well, I think that halftime really pushed us to bring some more intensity, which was good. I think that's what we're doing, but I think we just need to still chill out on offense so that we can bring the flow that we like.
Nice throws on offense in that last point, particularly that one which you did the assist.
Ooh, that was a little bit dodgy, but it worked, so.
Yeah.
Nice catch from Steph. Yeah. Oh, it's really fun. I just hope we...
Hazel, would you like to do a little guest spot too?
Guest spot.
Oh, sure. Hi.
So which of you is younger?
You or Helena?
Me, I think.
Helena is younger. There you go, you're ancient now.
Okay.
Inspirational words we have from Hazel.
So, how's your game going?
I'm loving it. This is so much fun.
Yeah. Really close game. They're always more fun.
Oh, look at that pole. I like watching discs fly. I don't say that every pole, only the beautiful ones.
I didn't say it when it was bricked.
I do sometimes say it when it's bricked because I don't know it's going to be bricked while I'm still admiring it.
Lots of fakes from Moore. A very bloody pass. Can they get under it? Almost caught. But the Moore players take each other out. Not the best strategy.
Leah catching it, sitting under it. One of her specialty moves to Sophie. Sophie to Penny. Penny, a nice long put straight to Beth. As a receiver for Penny, I always enjoy the way that she knows each player and how they get to things. She hasn't been at practice so much since she moved to Timaru, and so it's a bit trickier now. But that one to Beth looked to me like she'd been thinking about her for a while.
However, that swing pass was just out of Penny's reach. She could not get there.
Here we go, M for Moore, picking up, asking for an angled stack, I think.
They've swapped from their pearl play. Execution has gotten too good of their D on that. They've gone to a vertical stack. Disc is in. Lots of cuts, nice up the line. I believe there was a backhand break throw just before. And pressure from execution on the mark. A pop pass that did not come off.
Ah, good job, execution. Keep working on it. And a big
and
cut.
A huck. But no one is underneath it.
Sophie was thinking about it though.
Occasionally we call this playing for territory. So instead of throwing to a player, we just make it as far away from the other team's end zone as possible. It is often a cover story for a bad throw.
Or a miscommunication when you thought that someone was just going for it and it turns
and you
out
really
that they
them to.
Kind of slow down. Oh
and
my goodness,
again,
did you see
it
that?
It is tipped and yet Mua still catches it. They are very good at this.
flow again, and a nice backhand hook, a bit curvy, but the offender is underneath. Another flow pass, floating up, four players under the disc, though it's backed up by a Mua player.
She's looking for her very dump. Much on the, oh yeah, a lot of pressure on that throw. A lot of pressure on that throw. Wendy couldn't quite get there. Pretty sure that's Wendy. Yes. She does a lot of organizing of Ultimate and Massey in Palmerston North. So I get Facebook messages from her because I occasionally manage to make it to their pickup.
Beth almost backs it up, but it's just underneath her fingers. Setting up their vertical stack again. A nice backhand hook. Can Moore pull it down? No, the defender just gets there.
What good D.
And that is why you must always come to the frisbee. Solid advice.
Okay, back to execution.
Moore tries to make a bid, but is not there.
Leah.
Back to the handler. Too many Weet-Bix on that throw.
Moa picking up. It's M again.
The vertical stack's quite deep. It's coming closer. The first two cuts, neither were a good option. Next right. one work down the line. Lots of fakes.
Low
and a
pressure.
Dump back.
Nice. Execution right on these throws. Putting on the pressure, making the turn happen.
Forehand just wasn't floaty enough for any more player to get under it.
Seems like it's a little bit more effective when execution is working. 7-8 is the score. No, 2. Moore at the moment.
So our cameraman just was just called by execution.
Timeout called by execution.
They really want this point. They want to compose themselves, gives them an opportunity to do that.
Get a chance to breathe before just working it all the way in. That's my guess. Though who knows, we might see some sort of crazy ISO. But I think that Moore played too smart to do crazy ISO. After a timeout, the offense set up first, and then the defense work out how to go around what they've just set up. And so we'll see what shape execution choose.
Each team gets 3 timeouts per game, but they can only use a maximum of 2 in each half.
Okay, we're going to have a cheer from execution.
What's the solution?
Execution!
Let's go, execution!
Some skipping. Happy people. Always happy people.
That is, happy is the best way to play ultimate. Happiness makes good ultimate, and good ultimate makes happiness. This is how the world goes round.
So Jess, another one of our school's players, would you like to tell us how your game's been going?
Pretty good.
Are you having fun?
Yeah.
Yep. And are you playing happy ultimate?
Yes.
Yeah. Schools players, they're a little bit giggly. happy with the dog.
Sadly, the dog is not allowed to be a member of the team.
Yeah, he's just not very good at stopping moving after he's caught the disc.
I'm not sure his throwing skills are on point either.
He can throw. He can throw approximately a metre by flicking his head.
That's pretty impressive for a dog.
He normally throws to other dogs. He prefers to throw balls than discs. And he throws to other dogs.
Lua has now set up a zone.
Ooh.
Interesting turn of events. Will this put off execution or will they be able to break it? They're working it down the sideline where Moore has forced them to with their cup. They've broken it back with handler movement.
Oh.
That swing not completed though, too high.
Okay.
Moore's zone has been successful.
And picking up. Leah on the mark.
Moore needs more cutting options. Nice. Nice fakes, and they break to the handler, swinging it further across field. Oh, a nice break forehand, and a break backhand for the score.
Wow.
Goal.
Tricky situation, done well.
Was that Huda just for soft kick?
No, it'll be gamed. So if the Huda was before the point finished.
So the Huda that just went was soft cap. So they play out the point they were in, which is just finished, and add one to the highest score. So
game to 10.
Now a game to 10. And
score currently 7-9.
Tumua.
Okay, ready for the exciting comeback train execution.
They seem to be doing this comeback train in bursts. If they could hold it for just that bit longer, they might have it.
A three-point burst.
On the field feeling the intensity as they know this could be the final point of the game. Mua hoping it is. Execution determined to make that not serve.
Okay. Paul goes up. Floaty but not particularly long.
From Mua, forcing this line.
Ooh, break forehand from Hazel to Farron. Ooh.
That dump is too far behind Steph. She cannot get there. This is Mua's opportunity. Will they make it?
We've seen some very long games after the Huta, so we don't know.
Setting up their
but
vertical.
They'll certainly be concentrating now.
They need some cuts.
Oh yeah! Getting it back after throwing it away.
Redeeming herself slightly.
Totally! Oh no!
Oh, and another D!
And vice versa.
This is definitely Psycho D coming in this final point. Possibly final point.
Mua just informed us it is going to be the final point. It's certainly one of the match points. Come on, CP, get it back.
Mua just working it down the fourth side. Ooh, but just out of reach. Execution gets another opportunity. This is back and forth.
Come on, let's give them a long cut.
Disc is in. Nice pass from Steph. Oh, high contest for that disc.
Good on you for hanging on to it, Steph.
Everyone looks all right. A breakthrough, lovely.
To Sylvia, back to Emma.
Huck from Emma.
Oh, go Hillary, go Hillary, go Hillary. Yes!
And it is
brought down by Hillary.
As we say so often on Execution, goodness knows what proportion of our points she scores, but it's a high one. Okay. I'm calming down. Going to play my chili O now.
However, Execution has got to play their Psycho D, as they have just scored and will now come down on defense.
True.
They have to get this turn, or the game is over.
Yep.
It is a very serious time.
And you know, there's a serious smile on most people's faces.
That is the best way to play Ultimate, with a serious smile.
Yeah. Okay. So let's think about who's on the field, particularly for Mua. Let me have a think, because I don't know their names so instinctively, and I would like to call some more.
Pull goes up from Leah.
Nice pull.
But they get a pass off before the defense is set.
So 12, that's Asami. Picked it up. Liz
Handler's
just
working
threw
it
back to Asami.
They've gone to a vertical stack, I think.
You think? I thought it was horizontal.
I meant horizontal when I just said vertical. That is the word I meant to say. Dishy pass. She needs a bailout option. Someone has come to her aid.
Oh!
As we say, you should always go for the disc with two hands. Otherwise, that is what can result.
Keywern in the red hat, just not quite getting that catch. And now Execution are trying not to do the same thing back again.
Quick
nice safe throws.
Up the field.
Helena, the youngest player on the team, as we discovered before, 14. Getting the disc off, giving the disc to Liv and getting it back off her.
Execution needs more cuts.
And Leah diving just for it, but not quite coming up with the disc.
Just past Helena's fingertips, and Leah goes for the backup. Mua has another opportunity to end the game.
Hope you're watching along there, people. Because there's a terrible temptation at this point to just pick it up and throw it as far as you can.
Again, playing for territory. Will anyone get there?
Oh,
no, the Moore player cannot quite get to that.
Hazel picks up for Execution.
This is back
passes
in. A nice
to Steph.
Break pass.
Steph through the middle to Liv. Liv to Steph. Steph across to a
nice red D from Moore.
That's that person who we were talking about before, redeeming herself.
But just throws past the other Moore player's fingertips.
Steph picking up, throwing to the, oh, very hungry Helena, not quite grabbing it. Hungry
However, it
disc.
Was curving away from Helena. She made the best bid she could.
Yeah. Helena often gets dodgy throws, though, so I had my hopes. Okay, Jess on defense. Moore passing up the line.
A floaty pass from Moore. Can they get under it? Lots of plays under the disc.
Helena pushing it out. Two people chasing it just in case there was someone going after.
Helena is now playing for territory for the other team.
Hazel picks up. Injury. Oh.
So in the case of an injury, you may leave the field and have another player come on for you. However, it also gives that opportunity to the other team. they do not have to have an injured player to do so.
Okay, so here's the sub coming on.
Play resumes. Swinging across field.
Hand the movement. Nice continuation. Oh, nice up the line.
That's just magnetic hands.
Yes, yeah, scary one-handed catch there. Oh.
Moa keeping them on that line.
Oh, down through the defense.
Hammer.
And a hammer to Liv. With a nice, oh, yes.
And we go to Universe Point.
Exciting, overly exciting, but so pleased it's happening. So that was Liv to Helena, I think.
The question is, will Susan's dream come true of her team winning on Universe Point?
Ooh, 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 ooh. So our camera team are watching the replay. They said the relief on the thrower's face that was grabbed by Helena. Oh, nice job execution.
Can Mua get this one? Or execution be able to go the 3-for-3 that they needed to win?
Someone's just getting the score up there. Hazel's going across to help because they took a point off.
Apparently that point scored by Helena was a negative 1 point. Wasn't impressive enough to gain her team points.
Here we are. Universe Point at 9-all. These games are supposed to be to 15, but this has been so hard fought. Oh, we started late, actually, so our hooter probably wasn't the hooter. Oh, started late, ending on time. Okay, so it was our hooter. This is the Universe Point. I had a moment there where I thought, are we misleading everyone? Could be embarrassing, but no. What? Mammoth are just wandering off, not watching this exciting Universe Point?
Who do they think they are?
Probably people with a game to go to. Okay, picked up by Liz. M over the top.
Nice break pass.
Two.
We've got some chili over Moa. But too high. Was not between the eyes and the thighs for the receiver.
Okay.
Can execution use this for the win?
Surely,
Emma asking
yes.
for a dump.
Annie coming. Looking across for Emma again.
Ah, behind.
Down the line. Oh, yes, Hillary.
And yeah! Hillary scores for the win.
Oh, my God. You guys
and
did
so
well. And Moa played so beautifully. And it was really, really exciting. Thank you, everybody.
They are so excited with this win. It's really nice to see. They now realize they should probably high-five the other team, as that is now the spirited thing to do.
And I'm sure they're feeling very fond of those people, both sides. That was a beautiful game. Thank you, Zoe, for commentating with me.
And thank you, Susan.
I think that we might be doing some other games a bit later today. We'll find out. It's surprisingly fun commentating. Thank you, the people who were watching. Chewy something 69. Chewy the Wookiee. I have a feeling that's a Wellington youth player, but I'm not quite sure who.
But they seem to be referring to someone on the Moa team.
Oh, true. Okay, I've forgotten. I must be confusing YouTube handles. I don't spend enough time online, apparently.
They're all huddling up for their spirit circle.
Okay. Yeah, so thank you, everybody. Thank you, particularly players, for such a beautiful, exciting game that my team won even without me.
I hope you all enjoyed watching and listening to us. Thank you and goodbye.